afternoon, dear viewers. This is Akonja Atabon, your Gaza media correspondent in Yaounde. Last week, it was announced that the mortal remains of Reverend Father Etienne Ntellah Khumbah would be laid to rest on Friday, the 22nd of October, 2021. Yesterday, our literal Gaza media correspondent, Atemken Gilead, was there live during the removal, the burial, and the entertainment, and brought back this report.
Man was made from dust, and unto dust he shall return. Reverend Father Etienne Ntellah Khumbah respected this nature call on Sunday, 19 September 2021, and his funeral program took place on the 22nd of October 2021, beginning with the removal of the mortal remains from the Fako funeral home and procession to the Regional Parsis Cathedral at Small Support Buea. The ceremony started with a requiem mass, which was one of its kind, with several bishops, priests, reverend sisters, and other religious.
Spirit, suitable and faithful dispensers of the holy mysteries, so that by their ministry and example, the Christian people may be guided under your protection in the path of salvation through Christ our Lord. Amen.
After the requiem mass, the officiating bishop made some prayer petitions on his casket before burial.
Bless this grave and send your holy angel to watch over it. Forgive the sins of our brother and priest, whose body we bury here. Welcome him into your presence, and with your sins, let him rejoice in you forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The bishop also prayed for the peaceful repose of the soul of Father Etienne. He equally prayed for Jesus to raise Reverend Father Etienne on the resurrection day, as he made some prayer intentions.
Let us pray for our brother, to the Lord Jesus Christ, who said, I am the resurrection and the life. The man who believes in me will live even if he dies. And every living person who puts his faith in me will never suffer eternal death. Lord, you wept at the death of Lazarus, your friend. Comfort us in our sorrow. Lord, hear us.
Lord,
you raise the dead to life. Give our brother for our eternal life. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious, hear us.
You promised paradise to the faithful repentant. Bring our brother for our return to the joys of heaven. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Our brother for our return was washed through his baptism and anointed with the oil of salvation, giving fellowship with all your saints. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
He was nourished with your body and blood. Grant him a place at the table in your heavenly kingdom. Lord, hear
us. Lord, gracious hear us.
Comfort us in our sorrow at the death of our brother for the eternal. Let our faith be our consolation and eternal life our hope. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious hear us.
Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
An apostolic administrator of the Diocese of Manchester. My Lord, the Bishop of Buea, Khumbah, and Bishop Emeritus of Buea, Reverend Monsignors, Reverend Fathers, consecrated men and women, the natural family of Father Etienne Ntellah Khumbah, dear brothers and sisters in Christ, we gather here in small Sopo Buea to pay our last respects to a priest who has made history in the diocese of Buea and beyond. From Khumbah town through Manfe to Ikasa, where Father Etienne was appointed parish priest for the first time, he led a rather active life as he carried out the pastoral ministry assigned to him. It was in Bangem in 1991 that he got inspired to begin what he called the Maranatha Family of Jesus Prayer Group to protect the Bangem youths from the invasion of sects. Father Etienne's involvement in the Maranatha movement made him rather popular and famous. While he was in Bonjongo, people flocked to him from all directions for healing. It was probably on account of the fame he had acquired that he would not yield to the orders of his bishop when the bishop asked him to stop all activities of the Maranatha movement. His refusal to listen to his bishop earned him a suspension ad divinis, which forbade him from the exercise of every act of the power of orders. Since he would neither stop the Maranatha movement nor leave Bonjongo, he was taken manu militari from Bonjongo to Bishop's House Kumbo, where he stayed for some time. While Father Etienne was in Kumbo, his schoolmate and close associate, Professor Godfrey Banye Tangwa, visited him and asked him a rather challenging question. Given your conflict with the bishop and the great popularity of your prayer group, are you contemplating quitting the priesthood to continue with your charismatic healing ministry? Father Etienne's response was clear. Quitting the priesthood has never occurred to me. We are thankful to God that Father Etienne died a happy priest, having reconciled with his bishop and with everyone else. We thank you all for coming out in your numbers, in spite of the weather and the social climate, to accompany Father Etienne to his final resting place. We kindly request that you continue to pray for the soul of Father Etienne and for the souls of all the deceased members of the Association of Diocesan Priests of the Ecclesiastical Province of Bamenda, that they may rest in perfect peace. Amen.
The family head of the Khumbah's family was given an opportunity to say a word.
The Archbishop Bamenda, Your Excellency, the Archbishop, the other bishop that has accompanied him, the College of Priests, we are very grateful that today you have accompanied our brother who we get to priesthood about 46 years ago. And he has faithfully saved the Lord in that capacity. we, the family of Father Etienne Ntellah Khumbah, we are very grateful since the wake keep yesterday in Limbe. We say thank you to the Limbe and Water Deanery for participating massively at that wake keep. So what can we really say? We are made mortal on our own wake for our own day. Father Etienne, of course, we must at this very junction say much thanks to Father, to His Excellency to Michael D., the Bishop of Buea Catholic, all the religious, the ladies that pray with us during this moment of difficulties. It was not an easy thing for us to last year. The only son to this father and mother, given to Christy, who has done his job and he has gone. How can we remember him? Who can enter his shoe, this emblematic figure, who just by directing you to pray simple psalms and be very prayerful, you get healed? There are talents given by God, and he has done with his family.
The casket was then lowered, the tomb closed, and everyone left the cemetery, beginning from the bishop and other religious. Some key family members and Christians had this to say after the burial.
Ikem Kongbeza Dieudonne, father's younger brother and father's father at the same time. I'm so happy that finally father has been put to rest. I just pray that his spirit lives with us. The spirit of unity, the spirit of prayerfulness, and the spirit of godliness.
Please, can you tell our viewers your name? How connected are you to this family? And any message to well-wishers, sympathizers that have come to assist you bury the Reverend Father?
I am Kevin Gosson, the direct cousin to late Father Etienne. And since this morning, my impression, since this morning, we have been having rain right up to when we buried Father. I don't consider it a negative something. I think there are showers of blessing. Yeah, he lived his life by blessing people, by praying for people, by healing people. And today, he has been lowered to the next world. And we must not fail to thank the religious for all what they have done. The Bishop of Buea Catholic, Mike Ebb, his Lordship Mike Ebb, and all the Christians of the Limbe and Bota Deanery, which yesterday they make the wake keep with traditional dances and everything. They kept it up. And today, Father is gone. And then, as a family, we have decided to create a foundation. Reverend Father Ntellah Khumbah Foundation. So the Khumbahs are determined to continue with the spirit. Though we cannot do what he did, he has done with his talent, but we'll try to make that spirit of brotherlyhood alive, of living prayers, Maranatha, to continue within the Catholic domain. So, madam, I think this is exactly what we as a family are intending to do. We are really affected. We are mere mortals. It's God who decides, and then it is Him who has taken Father, and we accepted it as such. Even though within his religious, almost half a century of his priesthood, he died not even as a bishop or anything of sort. We know those things, but it's God who chooses. So we cannot judge. It is God alone who knows whatever he has to be. The others have gone right up to the position of Archbishop. Indeed, he has gone, and we as mere mortal, what can we do? We can only pray for his soul. and try to keep his spirit alive by continuous prayers.
From the Congi Parish, Santi. I hail from the BLM, Contemption Division. So Father Etienne has been a mentor to me, a religious mentor. Whatever problem I had, I went to Father Etienne, I came out with a solution. So he has impacted my life in several ways. He taught me how to be a Christian, how to be a good Christian, how to live well with my neighbor and other persons. So I think it is a big honor for us to come and give him the last respect today. That is why we are here in our good number.
Thank you, sir.
The part two of this same event was heavy refreshments, which began with prayer before meals, said by a priest, after which guests queued up to the food buffet.
Help is in the name of the Lord. The name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Papa God, we thank you for the life we are beginning, Father Etienne. Where you call him today, I need rest in peace. We thank you for these people where they don't come for Sika. If it touched their lives. Thank you for a natural family. We pray, say, as you don't bring them safely for here, and you don't present this chop, where they go chop for continue for glad for the long life where you give your picking and the good vocation where you give ye, make as we chop, remember for be generous too, all time, like for that 10 if it be. Remember for chop with the people they don't get at all. We chop with them in spirit. And above all, make this chop a gift we strong for continue for do that's all your holy will. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
A very important guest. You can see the VIP guests are queuing up.
Traditional dances then follow at the family compound in my 16 Buea.
For following us in today's program. Stay tuned to our subsequent programs and have a wonderful day ahead.